Many people may wonder why we are here spending time with strangers as though we were brothers, wearing the same kind of clothes, and living very simply. The fact is, all of us have the same goal in mind. It's a kind of goal that you have to close your eyes in order to understand it. If everyone is ready to get to know us, we'll be pleased to tell you our story.
Sawadee krab. My name is Didac. I'm from Barcelona, Spain. And it was very, very emotional. I cried, but it was tears of joy. And it was unbelievable to see so many people to come and cut your hair and rejoicing in your merit and sadu everywhere. It was very, very emotional. And I'm very grateful to have this opportunity, really, from the bottom of my heart. Kapun krab.
I am thinking, so this time, for the first time I am one lay person. Now it become a Buddha son.
My friends and I were here because we've been given the opportunity to ordain in the International Dhamma Dyada Ordination Program, which is being held for the fourth time. We have in our group altogether 14 people coming from 10 different countries. Really, we're just like a big family. Before the ordination, we spent time training ourselves and learning to recite the request for ordination. This recitation, which was new to all of us, but in the end, we all learned the words and were eventually allowed to ordain. We were all very happy, and so were our parents.
Estoy muy feliz de que Didac sea monje. Para mí ha sido muy especial poder compartir ese día con él. Y me siento muy feliz de estar en Tailandia, muy feliz de la paz, de la gente que he conocido aquí, que me han dejado compartir un montón de cosas con ellos y que he podido compartir el día de hoy con Didac y con todos sus compañeros. Nourished by food from those who believe. They practice and train through meditation. With Kanta we pass along at all times. Dhamma principles worth more than their own lives. Hope to stop rebirth, defeat tomorrow.
In fact, this time I take time off for a month to ordain as a monk. Yeah. So and this is always, you know, I want to do at least once in my lifetime.
Bueno, tuve una experiencia extremadamente hermosa cuando tuve mi ordenación en el templo de Punjab por el hecho de que fueron muchas emociones para mí porque fue una visión, como se dice en mi país, de que este templo lo vengo viendo de los 9 años y hoy por hoy estar haciendo una ordenación en este templo es extremadamente la emoción y muy lindo lo que me pasa y lo que me permitió Lumpok en lo que es la parte de la Dhammakaya en meditación.
When we arrived at Songkhla Wanaram in Chiang Mai province, we left our householder life behind in order to live the life of a monk. Although we sometimes see the lay people in the morning or during our Tudanka path, but everything here is beautifully marked by simplicity.
There's been many moments that were very touchy to me. But the other day we went for alms rounds, and it was the first time I went. And it was a weird feeling, because in one hand you are happy because they are giving you food and then you can eat, right? But on the other you see that people don't have much, but they are there every morning, very, very early in the morning, and they are giving you what they have. And they are doing that, happy doing that, and proud of doing that. I saw one grandmom, I guess, that she was almost crying looking at us, and that made me feel really, how can I say, I mean, happy, but sad at the same time. Because then you reflect on yourself and on your lay life, and you think, wow, I mean, when you're a lay person, everything is about having more or better and more of this, more of that. And she didn't have much, but she was happy to give it away. And then it makes you really, really think about things. I mean, being a monk is about your needs, not about what you want. It doesn't matter what you want, it's what you need. And not too much, not too little, just what you need.
Cleaning as a team together for many times, because especially, you know, before I was a monk and way before when I was working, I was in the Navy. So normally we also do a lot of chores. So actually this thing reminds me about, you know, teamwork, working together, you know, different people got different kind of character, but eventually we will get the work done, you know.
We can say that every second is spent training ourselves. So we are very grateful to our teaching monks and our mentor monks who were very patient and always ready to show us what to do. We humbly and deeply thank our most venerable Longpa for giving us the opportunity to ordain and to learn about this sublime life. Now, every time we close our eyes, we see the path that leads us to inner happiness.
The best meditation I have is a few days ago I was meditating, because you know meditation is on and off. So got a few of the session, I feel totally very relaxed. My body is very relaxed. It's like you forget about your body, you know. You just concentrate on your at the center. Then for a few moments I can see some lights, you know, some moving lights, you know, yellow lights and red lights, you know. Then after that I feel a sense of peaceful and happiness.
Well, meditations are good, are very sub-by. I feel very, very relaxed and comfortable. I try to focus on my center and then ignore the thoughts I have, because I always have thoughts.
So I try not to focus on them, and eventually they stop. And time seems to fly, because then you hear the blessing and you're like, whoa, really? The session is over? Okay, I guess that was good. And then you go smiling outside the meditation hall like nothing happened, and an hour went by and you didn't even realize. So sabay, maximum.
You see, our lives are now as bright as the candlelight. Our decision to ordain is like lighting the candle once, but once lit, it can provide our life with brightness and happiness for a long, long time to come. So many people wonder where true happiness is, and while they're still searching for this true happiness, I believe that my friends and I, we have already discovered it.